In this video, we're going to have a look at the first round of new features WriteSoft has added to our new WriteSuite Universal 2013 software. The place where we've improved our software probably with the broadest appeal is with WriteSoft's PDF features. The first thing we did with this tool is update the libraries that drive it. What this means for you is a faster PDF feature. Some of those larger PDF files that may have slowed down your program should operate much faster now. There should be significantly less lag when moving, clicking, dragging, or dropping something using our PDF feature. The second thing that we've added to the mix is the ability to rotate our PDF files. By right-clicking on the PDF itself, you can change the rotate angle. If I want to spin this 90 degrees, 180 degrees, or 270 degrees around, I can do that to optimize how it fits on my drawing screen. Though perhaps best of all is this. WriteSoft has added the ability to pan the PDF file. This is crucial for being able to line one file up on top of the other. I can simply import this file again, scale it, and just as I do with WriteSoft's AutoCAD feature, I can hold the Shift key to pan my drawing so that I'm able to position them on top of the other. By holding Shift, I can move my PDF file within the viewing window, so I'm no longer limited how far up and left I can move this file. I hold the Shift key, and I can move it within that viewing window, so I'm able to place these on top of each other. The next major set of improvements that we made were to our ceiling tools. WriteSoft has long had the ability to draw vaulted ceilings. But we now have the ability to edit the additional wall area added from your vaulted ceiling from any of our vaulted ceiling types on an individual basis. The default setting is as it always was, that these gabled ends here will automatically be added to my room's wall area. But if I so choose, I can separate that and manually adjust each of these individual wall materials. For instance, if one of these walls was adjacent to an attic space, rather than have a framed outside wall, I could make one of these walls an attic knee wall. In addition to allowing manual adjustment of its walls, there are more outputs on the ceiling property sheet. The ceiling's volume, surface area, and total wall area are now part of the ceiling property sheet so that a user might check their math to make sure that the way they're measuring the ceiling is accurate. Also available is the ability to, when using a shed roof, add a window to the high side of a shed wall. The program will now calculate this window as part of the load. But arguably best of all is WriteSoft's new dormer tool. With this tool here, I can add a dormer to a vaulted ceiling. We have two choices for dormers. We have a flat dormer or a gabled dormer, where you may choose the height of the dormer to the top of its wall, and in the case of a gable, an additional height to a vaulted area above that. I'm going to use a gabled dormer here. Now my H1 will be the distance from the beginning of that dormer area to the peak of its rectangular area here. We'll call that 5 feet. And H2 will be the measurement from the top of that wall there to the peak of its ridge in the center. I'll call that an additional 3 feet. Now there's something I want you to notice about this dormer. Do you see how it's a pale color? Now that indicates that this dormer is not correctly sized. WriteSoft has the ability to determine whether or not what you've drawn is geometrically possible. You see, as it turns out, this dormer does not extend back far enough to actually come in contact with my roofline. And as I continue to stretch that further back, WriteSoft is able to calculate where it intersects with the ceiling and measure that area. It's as if initially I tried to draw my dormer like so. By not extending it far enough back, it wasn't coming in contact with my roof. WriteSoft will only then show me the bold color when we've actually made the connection back to the roofline. And that's not the only thing we can do with this dormer tool. Just like our other vaulted ceiling options, we can individually adjust the wall materials for each surface of the dormer, front and each side. We can change the direction of the ridge of that dormer, should I need it to go in another direction. We can flip the front side to the other side, if it's needed over here, and obviously set the materials for the vaulted ceiling. You may also notice that there's a window tab on this dormer property sheet, where I can designate the dormer as having a window at the end, as most do, and then edit those window properties here on the dormer property sheet. Rightsoft has also added some grouping features to our multi-zone tree. If I want to take the rest of these bedrooms into this bedroom zone, all I have to do is use the control feature to group them together, along with my master bath, or the shift feature to select a range. Then just drag and drop them together. We've also added, for the ability to better analyze the calculations that you've done, the ability to print preview the component construction report on a room-by-room basis, so that you can find and analyze what building materials you've used where. And finally, Rightsoft has made some improvements to its high-velocity duct features. We've added the new Unico-specified 2.5-inch flex runs, as well as their variable-speed blowers. We've also added their parts to our part database, and set up their automatic takeoff rules as well for a better bill of materials. This concludes our video looking at the first round of new features we've added to our 2013 RightSuite Universal software. Thank you for your time, and have a good day.